Hello, I'm Chad Spearman with the CattleFax Closing Bell. The corn market has rallied sharply higher since mid-June, and the market is responding to declining crop conditions. Expectations are for another sharp decline in projected U.S. corn production in the August 10th crop production report from the USDA. It is expected to be revised 1 to 2 billion bushels lower from the July estimate at 12.97 billion bushels. With another sharp decline expected for new crop corn supplies, demand rationing will have to occur in the months ahead. U.S. corn export sales and shipments are already slowing. This week, the USDA released the weekly U.S. corn export data for the week ending July 19th. Old crop corn export shipments dropped to 20.2 million bushels for the week, dipping below the 28 million bushels per week pace needed to meet the USDA's current forecast of 1.6 billion bushels for the 2011 and 2012 marketing year, which ends on August 31st. If the shipment pace drops to record low levels for the balance of the year, exports could fall 25 to 50 million bushels short of the current projection. More importantly, the combination of sales booked for old and new crop were at a negative 5.5 billion bushels for the week. This was record low in the export sales data, which began in 1995. Old crop net sales declined 358,000 bushels, and new crop net sales declined 5.2 million bushels, driven largely by a cancellation of 9.5 million bushels destined to China. Given the current U.S. corn production outlook, corn prices will have to remain historically high for a sustained period to ration export demand for U.S. corn and limit new crop exports to less than the current USDA projection of 1.6 billion bushels for the new crop marketing year. New crop export sales of 258 million bushels have already been booked as of the July 19th data, which is currently the fifth largest total on record. The Fed cattle market was $1 to $2 higher this week, with light to moderate trade volumes. The bulk of the trade occurred at $114 to $115 per hundredweight on a live basis and $180 to $181 dressed. Feeder cattle prices were primarily steady for the week, while calf prices were $2 to $5 per hundredweight softer. Offerings are bigger than typically seen this time of year due to the drought conditions across much of the country. Slaughter cow prices were steady to lower, and offerings were large as producers are forced to liquidate part of the herd. Box beef cutout values were modestly lower for the week with moderate sales volume. Prices were relatively steady late in the week as buyer interest improved. Corn prices were volatile this week, but remain in a range at this time. Temperatures have cooled and showers have increased, but not enough to stem the drought. Thanks for watching, and remember to visit CattleFax.com to become a member and receive the latest market news and analysis.
The beef business has never been for the faint of heart. For more than 40 years, CattleFax has led the way. We're the time-proven leader in research, analysis, and information, equipped with the industry's most powerful database. Become a member at CattleFax.com.